So in the last class, we have discussed about the composite cross sections and its stresses, how to find the stresses in the composite cross sections. So today class, we need to discuss about the thermal stresses. We need to discuss about the thermal stresses, how the thermal stresses are induced in a component. So here in intermediate only we have studied that while the temperature is increasing, the dimensions of the component, will be varying. Therefore, we can remove the lid or a cork of a bottle by heating the neck of a bottle. While heating the neck of the bottle, we can observe that the bottleneck is expanded. So that our cork can be moved outside easily. So this is nothing but while increasing the temperature, the dimensions of the object will be changed. So here we can see that the thermal stress, when we increase the temperature or decrease the temperature, the body, its dimensions will be changed. Therefore, if I increase the temperature of a body capital AB, whose length is L, then the length of the object will be increased. That is nothing but it is free to expand. It is not restricted on its dimension. It can expand lengthwise, it can expand in widthwise while increasing a temperature. Therefore, here a strain, that is nothing but elongation, can be observed. The elongation can be observed due to the increasing of temperature. To find the elongation due to thermal effect, we have a formula that is alpha into T into L, where alpha is coefficient of linear expansion. So we have studied in intermediate. Next. T is nothing but the change of temperature. And L is nothing but length of the component. Using this formula, we can calculate the elongation, due to the temperature difference. So either it will be temperature may be raised or decreased. If I increase the temperature, the elongation will be increased. If I decrease the temperature, the elongation will be decreased. It is nothing but a compression. but it is free to expand. It is free to expand. The stresses will not develop in the component. Here the stresses will called as thermal stresses. The stresses will called as thermal stresses. So the stresses induced due to the stresses induced due to the temperature effect. We are not applying any external load on it. We are not applying any external load on it. We are applying the increase or decrease temperature on it. Therefore, the stresses induced by changing the temperature will cause thermal stresses. But the stresses are induced when the body is restricted to expand. When the body is free, restricted to free expand, when the body is restricted to free expand, then only the thermal stresses will be developed component. Then only the thermal stresses will be developed in the component. Then only the thermal stresses will be applied or induced in the component. Therefore, if a component is considered like this, I have increased the temperature by a furnace, therefore the length is increasing. If I restricted the length by a wall, then it cannot expand freely. Therefore, a compressive load is applied on the body. This compressive load, due to this compressive load, a stress will be developed until I restricted to free to expand. So please read this sentence, Amma. The thermal stresses are the stresses induced in a body due to the change of temperature. The thermal stresses are set up in a body when the temperature of the body is raised or lowered, and the body is not allowed to expand. That means it is free to expand, means there will not be any stresses. If it is free to expand, means there will not be any stresses. When we arrest the expansion only, then the stresses will be induced in the component. That stresses will called as thermal stresses. So here the statement is, but if the body is allowed to expand freely, there is no stresses induced in the body. There will not be any stresses in the body. So here, linear expansion of coefficient alpha is very, very important of that material. Each and every material will have different of a expansion coefficient. According to the temperature, it will be varying. So here, delta L can be measured by using alpha, that is linear expansion of coefficient of that material, into temperature difference into length of that component. So if you see here, the temperature difference has, it is a difference, it has a units of degree centigrade or Fahrenheit, and length has a units of centimeter or mm or meters, and the change of length must be again in centimeters or mm's. Therefore, I need to cancel the degrees of centigrade. Therefore, the alpha has a units of per degree centigrade. Per degree centigrade or per degree Fahrenheit. It gives the value of a magnitude per degree centigrade. So if I increase some 1 degree, if I increase 1 degree, this much of magnitude, he will give us some constant sum. This much of magnitude, it will be expanding for different materials. It may be very, very small. It may be a very, very small. So 0.00005,
something
else like that, it will be. Increase, the elongation will be somewhat lesser here. How to find the stresses? How to find the stresses? So the stress, we know the relation, that is stress and strain. So we have now know the strain, that is nothing but change of length by original length is nothing but a strain. Here we'll call it as a thermal strain. And we know that strain in terms of stresses, that is nothing but thermal stress by Young's modulus. Young's modulus of that component. Young's modulus of component. So here we know that Young's modulus is equal to stress by strain. Therefore, stress is equal to strain into Young's modulus. Strain into Young's modulus. Therefore, strain can be written as alpha into T. Alpha into T into Young's modulus. That gives the thermal stress. That gives the thermal stress. How to find the external load? How to find the external load due to this thermal stress? So I am not applying any external load, but the external load is created due to the constraining effect. The external load is created due to the constraining effect. Therefore, how to find the whatever the external load is applied on the component? So to find the external load, we can use the formula load is equal to stress into area. So here the stress is nothing but a thermal stress. So the whatever the external load due to the constraining effect applied on it is stress into area. Therefore, stress value is nothing but alpha into t. Here T is nothing but temperature difference. It is the temperature difference, and capital E is the Young's modulus of that material into area of the cross-sectional area of that component gives the whatever the load applied due to this external effect, that is constraining the object. So this is the thermal stress in a component. So we are doing some problem on it. So here we are discussing a problem. A steel rod of 3 centimeter diameter, 3 centimeter diameter and 5 meters long is connected to a rigid grips. So there is a grips on the both ends, 2 rigid grips, and the rod is maintained at a temperature of 95 degrees centigrade. 95 degrees centigrade. 95 degrees centigrade. Determine the stresses and pull, that is nothing but load. when a temperature is fall to 30 degrees centigrade. When the temperature is fall to 30 degrees centigrade. So initially the temperature is 95 degrees. Initially the temperature is 95 degrees. Now the temperature is 30 degrees centigrade. So I am considering this a rod whose diameter is 3 centimeter and rigidly fixed on the both ends. Rigidly fixed on both ends. And the length of the rod here given as 5 meters. Now the temperature is 95 degrees centigrade. Now the temperature reduced by 30 degrees. Now at the present the temperature is 30 degrees. So due to this reducing of temperature, the rod will be condensed. That is nothing but its dimension will be decreased. But it is rigidly fixed on the both ends, so it cannot decrease its dimension. That means a tensile force is applied on a component ends. A tensile force is applied on a component to make it as similar process. That is as a standard dimension, because the rigids cannot move. The rigids cannot move among. Its length should be the same. Therefore, a tensile load will be occurred on a component. So I need to find out what is the tensile load. What will be the tensile load in that component? So for that, he had given the diameter. And I can find the area by using the formula. Next, he had given the initial temperature and final temperature. I need the change of temperature. So it is nothing but 65 degrees centigrade. And he had given the Young's modulus of that component and he had given the alpha value, that is coefficient of linear expansion in degree centigrade. Therefore this is also in degree centigrade. Therefore I can directly substitute in my formula. The formula here is, so directly he needs the stress as well as load. So I need the formula. Stress is equal to, we have derived the stress formula, is equal to strain, thermal strain into Young's modulus, where thermal strain is alpha into temperature difference. Alpha into temperature difference into Young's modulus gives the stress in the component. Therefore, applying the values, here the Young's modulus is given in meter, that is mega Newton per meter square. But all values are in mm's. So I need to convert this also. So convert this. So I need to convert this meter into mm. Therefore, one meter is equal to 10 to the power of 3 mm. 1 meter is equal to 10 to the power of 3 mm. Therefore, I will get mega, I can write it as 10 to the power of 6. Mega, I can write it as 10 to the power of 6 into Newton by, for this, I will get 10 to the power of 6 mm square. Therefore, 10 to the power of 6 and 10 to the power of 6 will be cancelled. Therefore, I can write it as 1 mega Newton per meter square is also equal to 1 Newton per mm square. Therefore, I can write this value directly, or I can convert this. I can convert this and substitute the values. We can find the stress. We can find the stress. We can find the stress. So it is in nature of a tensile. The stress is in a nature of a tensile because the body is feeling a tensile. Actually, its dimension is reducing. Actually, due to the decreasing of temperature, due to the decreasing of temperature, the length, that is delta L, will be decreased. But we have constraint on the both sides. We have constraint on the both sides. Therefore, a tensile force will be created on the component such that to make it as a standard dimension, that is 5 meters. So a tensile force will be created. So how to find the tensile force? How to find the tensile force? So already we had tensile force is equal to stress into area. Therefore area we have calculated and stress we have calculated. So we can multiply both and we can find the force that is induced in the component to make the component in 5 meters length, to stay the component for a 5 meters length. That is the first case. We are not considering yielding effect. Next, second case, we need to consider yielding effect above. Second case, we are giving that yielding effect is considered. What is yielding? So, if any gap is there in between the rigids, if any gap is there in between the limits, that is grips, therefore if I increase the temperature up to here, it will be freely expanded. Then only the restricted of expansion is occurred. Therefore, a compressive load will be occurred here. When I increase the temperature, this type of called as a yielding effect amount. So he had given a free, that is a 1.2 mm gap between the grippers. But here a tensile load, due to the temperature decrease, a tensile load is created and a compressive yielding effect will be created here. Therefore, delta L will be a negative. Always it will be a value of a opposite to the thermal effect. Opposite effect. Therefore, So we can use the formula. We can use the formula that is stress is equal to thermal stress minus delta into capital E. So delta by L is nothing but again a strain. Strain into capital E. Here we are considering the both effect. That is strain due to the thermal minus strain due to the loading, compressive loading or a tensile loading. That is nothing but delta L by L.
Yeah,
delta L by L. Therefore, combining this effect, we'll get the stress induced due to the point as 1.2 mm. There is a gap between the grippers is 1.2 mm. Therefore, I can find the load in the similar manner. Only the difference here is delta L need to be considered in my formula. Whatever the delta, you had given it. So this is the first problem in thermal effect. Second concept is, thermal stresses in composite bars. So here two different materials are combined to prepare a single component. Now I increase the temperature. Now I have increased my temperature. Therefore, while increasing the temperature, the brass has a tendency to expand more than the steel. The brass has a tendency to move or expand more than the steel. So it is expanding more due to the increasing of temperature. But we are concentrating on the effect. We are concentrating the both. Therefore, the brass in compressive nature. The brass feels a compressive nature. In the same time, the steel feels a tensile nature. So in the intermediate, you have studied the biometric stipama. So two different materials for a refrigerator controlling the circuit, compressor circuit. Compressor, that is a compressor current circuit is a biometric stipama there. So if the temperature increase or decrease, the stip will be expanded or decreases the trace so that the current flow for the condenser of the refrigerator will be controlled by using this trick. By using this trick. So here the same trick, we need to design a component with a composite bars. So that is nothing but two different materials and two different cross sections are combined to form a single component to create that is nothing but it cannot expand or contract individually. A combined expansion or a combined contraction will be seen in the component while the increasing of temperature or decreasing of temperature. So that is the topic of thermal stresses in composite bars. So we need to do a problem on it, Amma. Here also in the yesterday problems like that only. A tube is considered, Amma. A tube is considered a steel tube of 30 mm external diameter and 25 mm internal diameter enclosed in a rod of 20 mm diameter. That is nothing but the inner diameter is 25 and outer diameter is 30. And a rod inside it whose diameter is 20 mm are rigidly fixed now by using a nut and bolts again like the yesterday problem. Now the temperature initially it is 140 degrees centigrade. The temperature is 140 degrees centigrade and it is falls to 30 degrees centigrade. Here the inside rod is made up of different material. The inside rod is made up of gun metal. Inside rod is made up of gun metal and the tube is made up of steel. The temperature difference is again, the temperature initial temperature is T1 is 140 degrees centigrade and T2 is 30 degrees centigrade. And the Young's modulus of the steel is given. And the Young's modulus of gunmetal is given. The Young's modulus of steel is given, and the Young's modulus of gunmetal is given. And a linear coefficient of steel and gunmetal is also given. These are the given values, and we need to find out the stresses. We need to find out the stresses induced in the component due to the decrease of temperature from 140 to 30 degrees. So this is a problem like your previous composite bar. So it is nothing but a tube inside a rod. The same problem like this. A tube which is made up of steel and a rod is made up of a gun metal. And nuts are tightening the both. Now the initial temperature here is 130 degrees centigrade. Initial temperature of this is 140 degrees centigrade and the final temperature is 30 degrees centigrade. So here it is a composite effect it is a composite effect. The elongation in the rod must be equal to the elongation in the tube. The elongation in the rod must be equal to the elongation in the tube. And the total external load must be equal to the load taken by the tube by plus load taken by the rod. The total external load is not given, it is zero. Therefore, whatever the load taken by the tube is also equal to the load taken by the rod. Therefore, load can be written as stress into area, of the tube, and the stress in the rod into area of the rod. So that is the formula he had written here. Therefore, we are getting a relation. Between the two stresses. That is, stress in the steel is equal to some constant into stress in the gunmetal. Next. So here we need to observe the alpha value of alpha values of both metals. So here if you observe these two values, which one is more ductile? I need to decide that which one is more ductile, that is, which one will elong more in these two values only. Due to one degree centigrade increase, which material will expand more? So if you see this, it is 12. If you see this, it is 20. So if you see the values also, 10 to the power of 6, both are 20, 10 to the power of 6. Therefore, the gun metal will have more ductile. That means it will increase more than the steel. The gun metal will increase more than the steel. The steel will be increased slowly. The steel will increase slowly. But the gun metal, by increasing only, the both has by increased by, the temperature is increased by 1 degree centigrade. But the gun metal will be increased more, because the value here is more. Therefore, it will be increased more than the steel. Therefore, the steel creates a compressive nature on the gunmetal such that both are constrained each other. Therefore, the gunmetal feels a compressive in nature. In the same time, the steel feels a tensile. Both are constrained each other. Ee rendu kalipi kattesamma ఒకటి బాగా పెరగాలి, ఒకటి స్లోగా పెరుగుతుంది. అప్పుడు ఏమవుతుంది? బాగా పెరిగేదేమో కొంచెం తగ్గించుకుంటుంది, స్లోగా పెరిగేదేమో కొంచెం పెంచుకుంటుంది. దేర్ఫోర్ ద స్టీల్ ఫీల్స్ ఎ టెన్సైల్ అండ్ ద గన్ మెటల్ ఫీల్స్ ఎ కంప్రెషన్. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద ఎక్స్ప్లనేషన్ ఈస్ గివెన్ ఇన్ దిస్ పారా. సో దట్ ఈస్ the alpha s, that is steel coefficient of steel into temperature difference, plus l, that is length of the rod or a tube. Steel is here tube, plus, so why to write here plus? Here it is a feeling a tensile in nature. It is feeling a tensile in nature. The steel feels a tensile in nature. Therefore, stress in the steel tube by Young's modulus of steel into L. That gives the elongation in the steel tube. That gives the elongation in the steel tube. Same. What is the elongation or expansion in the gunmetal? In the gunmetal. So here the gunmetal feels a compressive nature. Therefore, a gunmetal feels a compressive nature. Therefore, a negative need to be considered. Negative need to be considered, and this is the thermal stress, that is thermal strain or thermal elongation, and due to this is the effect of constraining effect, that is stress due to the gun metal and Young's modulus of the gun metal into length of the component. These both are constrained in the same single component. Therefore, they two must be equal. These two must be equal. And therefore, I am equating these both. These are the steel's equation. This is the steel equations. And this is the gunmetal equation. So I need to equate these two. Therefore, L will be cancelled. And substituting all the values. So here we have two unknowns. We have two unknowns, that is stress in the steel is an unknown, as well as stress in the gunmetal is also unknown. But in the previous we have a relation between these two. Therefore, substituting that relation, I can find the one unknown. And remaining can be found by using this formula again. So using this formula, we can find the stresses induced in a composite bars when a thermal effect is considered on it. So with this, I am closing the thermal effect amount. So please do the problem. I will send this PowerPoint for you. So do the problem on this. Next. Next topic is elongation of the bar due to its self weight. Up to now we have studied when the external load is applied on the body, the elongation, when the external load applied on the component, its elongation we have studied. But due to its self weight, due to its own weight, we have not studied up to now. So how to find the elongation in a component due to its own weight? So here a component, it is uniformly cross-sectional component, is considered uniformly cross-sectional. That is, uniformly cross-sectional area is considered in between A to B, whose length is L. And Young's modulus of that material is considered. And weight is nothing but specific weight amount here. Small w is the specific weight. per unit volume. So we'll also call as a density. will also called as a rho or small w, density of that material. Density of that material. So here I am considering a small element. I am considering a small element at a distance of small x from the free end, whose thickness of the element is dx. Will also called as length of the element. Length of the element. Now I am considering only the length of that element, and I need to find the force applied on that element. I need to find the force applied on the element. What is the force applied on the element? So how to find the force? So here I need to find out the volume under that element. I need to find out the volume under the element. So it is a circular rod whose area is capital A, and the length of the rod under that element is x. Under the element is x. So this gives the volume. It gives the volume of the component. It gives the volume of the component. Volume is equal to area into length. Therefore here length under the element, we are considering the under the element, is nothing but A into x. A into x. A into x. So that gives the volume. So how to find the force? How to find the force? To find the force, to find the force, I need to consider the weight. So how to find the weight again? Weight can be considered by weight can be found by density into volume. Density into volume is nothing but weight of the component under the element. Under the element. Therefore, I need to find out the weight that is applied on the element. What is the weight applied under the small element whose length is dx? Whose length is dx now? After finding the load, after finding the load, after finding the load, I can find the stress. I can find the stress on the element. Stress on the elemental strip. That is nothing but load by area. Stress in elemental strip is nothing but load by area. So the load is nothing but density again. Density into area into length is here x divided by here area. Again the same area, area will be cancelled. Therefore we are getting the stress in terms of density into x. Density into x. Next, how to find the strain? After finding the stress, how to find the strain? Strain is nothing but stress by Young's modulus. Therefore substituting the stress value, substituting the stress value rho into x by e. How to find the elongation in the elemental strip? how to find the elongation in the elemental strip. So I need to multiply the length of the strip, elemental strip, that is nothing but dx. Length of the strip is nothing but dx. So this is the elongation. This is the elongation in the elemental strip. This is the elongation in this strip due to the load under the body. That is self weight. We will call it as a self weight under this strip. Under this strip. Therefore, if I need the total elongation due to the total elongation due to the self weight, I need to do the integrals. I need to do the integrals. The limits is 0 to L. The limits is 0 to L. Therefore, integral 0 to L. And here density can be taken out and Young's modulus can be taken out. Therefore, x dx. So integral of x is nothing but x square by 2. Applying the upper limit and lower limit. We can find the elongation of the rod. Elongation of the rod when its self weight is considered. So in the previous classes, we are not considering its self weights. We are considering only the external load applied on the component. So now we need to consider the self weight of the component by considering the formula, that is delta L. We can calculate the delta L of the rod or something else by using this formula. Delta L in the rod is equal to W. Here small w represents the density. Density, that is of the component. Density of that component. And the L represents the length of the component whole square by Young's modulus into 2. So here capital W can be written as, that is weight can be written as density into length. Therefore, here written this capital W into L by 2E is the elongation in the a component due to its self weight. So with this, I am concluding the section. Only one topic is remaining in the first chapter, that is uniform strength in a component. So with this, first chapter is completed, will be completed, that is nothing but uniaxial directions. So up to now we have studied only uniaxial directions, only one directional load is applied on the component. Only one direction, either it may be x direction, either it may be a y direction, either it may be a z direction. A component, a uniaxial, that is nothing but only one load is applied on the component. That is only we have completed now. In the next class, we will discuss about the biaxial stresses, triaxial stresses also. So with this, I am closing the section.